I will now express that five statements. First statement, listen. If there can be second, there is infinity. If there is a second fish, the possibility for infinite fishes is there. If there is a second cow, the possibility for infinite number of cows are there. If there is a second human being, the possibility for infinite number of human beings are there. If there is a second for anything, it is infinity. The possibility for infinity exists. This is the first statement. Second, please listen carefully. Each one of you are universe. I'll tell you, each one of you. Listen. Each one of you are universe. This is the second statement. Third statement. All of you have the seeking for something unique only you have. All of you, deep in your heart, believe there is something unique only you have and seek that, search for that, try to discover that, try to find that. This is the third statement. Listen, all of you, by your nature, by your simple existence, you are searching for what is unique in you, what makes you the ultimate unique, which nobody else has, only you have. All of you have confidence that there is something only you have, others don't have, and all of you are seeking what is that. This is the third statement. The fourth statement. What is in you that is seeking your uniqueness? That is unique. What is it that is unique in you? Actually, who is searching? That there is something in you which is searching your uniqueness. That is unique for you. Means, your consciousness is unique only for yourself. Fourth statement. Your consciousness is unique only for yourself. And this fifth statement is the most important statement. It is beyond paradoxical. It is beyond paradoxical. Listen, if you actually meditate and do Vakyartha Sadasa on this statement, not only you will get enlightened, you will manifest whatever you want in the life. Because the part of your brain which is responsible for Ishwaratva, getting whatever you want, that part of the brain will be kindled by this fifth truth. Listen. The fifth truth. Listen. The consciousness you have, which tries to search your uniqueness, whether you eat pizza and enjoy some taste, or you acquire money and build some identity, or you gain name and fame, anything you do, you are searching for your uniqueness. That which searches your uniqueness in you is your uniqueness. That is your consciousness. And listen to the fifth statement. Your consciousness and all each one's universe is one and the same. Infinite number of universes and your unique consciousness is one and the same. This is the fifth statement. This can make you enlightened just like that. Just by doing Vakyartha Sadas, listen, the consciousness only you have and the universes each one has, both are one and the same. Listen to the conclusion. Existence of Paramashiva, being of Paramashiva, identity of Paramashiva, all three are one and the same in their manifest and unmanifest states. Same way, your unique consciousness only which you have, and the universes each one of you have, is one and the same. Now, just sit. Don't think only you are not able to understand. Actually, if you understood all the statements I made, you have not heard it properly. If you hear it properly, you will understand. It's not related to binary logic. It's cosmic logic.